I think now is a decent time to keep an eye on commodities, keep an eye on the US dollar and gold, silver, look at the ags, look at wheat, corn, beans. They've been beaten down. Farmers have had a hard time. We have an election in 2020, potential trade deal. There's a lot of things that I think would make sense politically to push those prices up. If the dollar comes off, everything priced in the dollar is going to have a big rally. And I think that there's a chance that inflation picks up again. That's been talked about for 5 or 10 years, I know, but there's a lot of things leaning that way. And if stocks take a breather, commodities tend to do well when stocks struggle. And we've had interest rates have a pretty steady move down after the Fed reversed course a few months ago. So the way I like to play this is to not get too caught up in these macro type trades, but when I have a stronger idea, which I'm starting to build now, is put some options on and some stuff and give myself 6 to 9 months of room and get my risk locked in ahead of time, and then go back to my more micro focused trades that are stock stories and things that are more here and now and less about trying to predict the weather. Predicting the weather is a tough business, but sometimes there's a lot of things that line up that make it a good thing to do. You just have to manage it right so you don't get consumed with it. And if it does work out the right way and your macro forecasts are correct, you can find little trades to kind of go with that trend when it starts developing. But it's something that needs to be put in its place, put in its correct place. And in the past, I've gotten too carried away with this and it's distracted me. So I'm long some Euro futures right now. That's one way I'm playing it. And I'm going to kind of keep an eye on the whole space. Everything from solar to gold and oil to, I'm going to watch the ratio of copper to precious metals and see how that's holding up. It should be rallying with the stock market. It has been lately. Sometimes when it diverges, like before the market took a dive in December, you could see it diverging where precious metals were outperforming copper for a while. I like to watch things like that. Stock market isn't always the smartest market. Usually the bond market moves sooner. Not even the bond market, but the relationship of junk bonds to treasury bonds and things like that are important to watch. Our junk bonds are outperforming treasury bonds when the stock market's rallying. If it's not, then it's just another data point. So I'm collecting a lot of these data points for commodities right now, and it seems to me that commodities could have their day sooner than later, and sooner might mean months to a year, not 5 years. And I could be wrong on that, but I'm willing to take a 6 to 9 month bet and protect myself with options or stops in my futures positions, and then go back to the short-term stuff, which is not as concerned with these bigger predictions. Doesn't matter about the weather as much when you keep it short, but when you get longer, you can get obsessed with your idea and think that you're right and discuss why you're right. And sometimes I overthink it, and it's best to just put it on and walk away, I think, and then go from there. So that's what I'm going to do with this idea, and generally looking to play an anti-dollar idea, which could... The other thing I want to say about it, though, is if you think something's going to happen in commodities and then you end up playing... Say you think corn's going to go up, so you buy corn-related stocks. A lot of times, those things don't go up and corn does go up, and then you're pissed off because you had the right idea but you didn't make money. Like oil goes up, but oil equities don't go up. So I'm going to have to make as direct of a bet as I can, because I've seen in the past where sometimes you don't get paid on your idea if your bet doesn't match what you think. So you don't want to get too cute with it. So that's also something I'm going to pay attention to this time. I've learned that from the past many times, actually. So that's it for today.